Hi friends, I am Dr. B.V. Rao of Usha Clinic and founder of the website qmedicaldoubts.blogspot.in and raghavamedicaldoubts.com. Through these videos, I am providing the basic knowledge about the commonly occurring diseases, treatment and surgery details when necessary. For the medical knowledge to general people and for reference to medicals. Today I am going to discuss about the disorders of scrotum. Prepenile scrotum. It is a very rare congenital condition. The scrotum is suspended from the mons pubis. It is situated anterior to the penis. Idiopathic gangrene of scrotum. Borneo's gangrene. Of course, it is rare but is fearful in effect. The three cardinal characteristics of this disease are sudden appearance of scrotal inflammation, rapid onset of gangrene, absence of any cause in majority of cases. It is known to follow minor injuries or procedures in the perineum as a bruise, scratch, dilatation of stricture, injection of anal fissure or opening a periurethral abscess. It is a vascular disaster of infective origin. Organisms. The hemolytic streptococcus associated with other organisms like staphylococci, E. coli, Clostridium belchae set up fulminating inflammation within the scrotal subcutaneous tissues resulting in obliterative arteritis of the arterioles supplying the overlying skin. Clinical features. Sudden onset of scrotal pain, prostration and pyrexia. At first only scrotum is involved. If neglected, cellulitis spreads along those planes so well known in superficial extravasation of urine. In occasions, entire scrotal covering slough, leaving the testis hanging exposed bored to their tunica, free from gangrene. Treatment. Chloramphenicol is the drug of choice till the report of a bacteriological report comes. Topical application of antibiotic is also helpful. Ciporin in large doses may be used if organism is sensitive. If no response, the scrotum should be incised. If gangrene has commenced, wide excision of all sloughing areas saves time, rids the patient of scrotal tissue that is doomed, provides the freest possible drainage and stops the spread of gangrene. Filarial elephantiasis of scrotum. It is caused by obstruction of the lymphatic vessels of pelvis by Escherichia bancrofti. Superadded infection and lymphangitis. It is common in tropics and subtropics. The earliest symptom is the funiculitis with the development of a secondary hydrocele. Repeated attacks cause the scrotum to remain edematous and the scrotal skin and subcutaneous tissue greatly thickens. In case of long-standing cases, the scrotum becomes immense and the penis is buried within it. Treatment. There is no medical treatment for this condition. Operative treatment. The principle of surgery is the construction of a new lymphatic pathway. This can be accomplished by cellular cutaneous bridges of generous size, uniting the scrotum to the thigh as in the Ketley's toric operation, thus permitting the scrotal lymph to be absorbed in the involved thighs. In advanced cases, the excision of all involved skin together with the implantation of testes into the thigh and a skin grafting of the barred skin of penis is the only curative treatment. It should be noted that the inner layer of the prepuce is rarely involved. It should therefore spread and can be used to cover the bare shaft of the penis. Bovisman. In all cases, concomitant hydrocele are dealt with by excision of the sac at the time of operation. Non-filarial elephantiasis. It is caused by the sclerosis of the lymphatic vessels due to lymphogranuloma venereum. Non-filarial elephantiasis never reaches extravagant proportions of tropical elephantiasis. There is no effective medical treatment. The scrotum thigh cutaneous tunnel operation described above is recommended. Sebaceous cysts of scrotum. There are usually small and multiple. Sometimes large sebaceous cysts may suppurate, and when it does so, the water is particularly obnoxious and may be mistaken for a carcinoma of scrotum, which calls to mind Koch's peculiar tumor. Carcinoma of scrotum. Squamous epithelioma of scrotum was rife among chimney sweeps. With improved working conditions, this occupational disease ceased to exist. In as far as chimney sweeps were concerned, but with mechanization of cotton industry, lubricating oil from the spinning jenny soaked the crutch of the mule spinners' trousers and proved more carcinogenic than soot. Now that a lubricating oil free from impurities has been substituted, it is hoped that carcinoma of the scrotum will no longer attack mule spinners. In particular, a few cases still occur in tar and shale workers, but in the majority of cases encountered at the present time, there is no etiological factor. It is remarkable that in contradiction to carcinoma of penis, that odd scrotum is almost unknown in India and Asiatic countries. Clinical features. The growth starts in a wart or an ulcer, and as it extends may involve the underlying testes. Treatment. The growth together with a considerable margin of healthy tissue is excised by diathermy. If inguinal lymph nodes are enlarged and do not subside with the antibiotic treatment, a block dissection of these nodes and the external iliac nodes should be carried out, usually on both sides. That's all about the disorders of the scrotum, and in the next video I will discuss about some other disease. Thank you.